Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to IWS 2022 warm-up, the online technical conference preparing to IWS 4th edition. First of all, let me thank you all for coming here today. Let me introduce myself. I'm Virginia, one of Bell Campus organizers. The topic of today's presentation is a new equation for flow through surface choke involving digital field calculation. The last minute of presentation will be the question and answer part. Please write your question in the chat box. It's now my pleasure to present Pier Paolo Mandolesi, process engineer at TechFirm. Thank you so much and have a good presentation. Pier Paolo, can you start?
Welcome at all, I'm Pier Paolo Mandolesi, a junior process engineer at TechFirm SPA, and I'm here in order to discuss and present the work made by me and Giambattista De Ghetto, a professor of oil and gas field development and production at Polytechnic of Milan. Our work is called New Equation for Flow Through Surface Choke Valve in Digital Field Calculation. So, just a few words about myself. I'm Pier Paolo Mandolesi, I'm a junior process engineer. I work at TechFirm SPA since 2019. TechFirm is an oil and gas company located in Fano. I graduated in Earth Research Engineering curriculum offshore at University of Bologna in 2019. During my study, I did an internship at Eni SPA in the production unit of the DIX Ravenna. And during this period, I started to develop in collaboration of Giambattista De Ghetto this work. And at Eni I studied practical cases of critical and subcritical multiphase flow performance through wellhead choke, and I gathered a lot of input data that I used in this work. The main objective of our work is to found a new equation or correlation for multiphase flow through wellhead choke estimation. We will start with a brief introduction of choke valve, that is the object of our study, and the behavior of the fluid that flow through a choke. Then, after a detailed literature analysis, we select the widely used models present in the literature in order to compare them with the new equation. Before the explanation of the new equation, we want to remark the importance of the development of field digitalization in order to better understand the importance of new equation that we will explain in detail later. Then we talk about the methodology of work, and finally we will show you the results of each existing models and the new equation tested by using the same field database. On the results, for sure, are based the conclusion of our work. Well, we can start with the brief introduction of the choke valve, that is the object of our study. The wellhead choke valve is the most important valve in oil and gas industry, used to regulate the hydrocarbon produced by the wells. And many reasons may make it desirable to restrict well production rate, including, for example, the prevention of water conning, to keep stable pressure downstream of the choke, to provide the necessary back pressure to the reservoir in order to avoid formation damage. Most of all, the choke valve regulation allows to give the optimal oil gas flow rate in field, prevent for sure water arrival, and allow us to have measure sand control. In the figure is represented a angle choke valve in an offshore field application, but in the market are present many type of choke valve, for example needle and seat choke, multiple orifice choke, and fixed beam choke. A correct understanding of how the fluid behaves during the flow is very crucial in order to design a production system capable to produce with high efficiency. In fact, a good choke performance model can considerably contribute to the accuracy of well performance prediction that can have a significant impact on the productivity and rentability of the entire project. In the figure is shown a simple sketch of a choke. There are three important flow conditions in choke modeling. The first is represented by the number one in the figure that shows the upstream condition, where the inlet parameters such as pressure, temperature and velocity are measured. The second important part to be considered is the choke flow condition, where the flow is accelerated through the restriction and the pressure drop occurs. The condition 3 indicates the downstream position, where the fluid flow reaches the pipe and have homogeneous velocity again. The outlet parameters, such as pressure, temperature and velocity, are also measured at this position. So this figure is very important in order to understand the behavior of the fluid that flow through a wellhead choke. Related mainly to the pressure difference across the choke, two different flow regimes may occur during fluid flow through a choke: critical and subcritical. The critical flow occurs when the velocity through the choke is greater than the sonic velocity of the fluid. For fluids with a velocity greater than the sonic velocity, any downstream perturbation is unable to propagate upstream, and the mass flow rate is function only of the upstream parameters. In other words, in a critical flow region, the mass flow rate reaches a maximum value that is independent of a pressure drop applied across the choke. Once critical flow is reached, any disturbance introduced downstream of the choke will have no effect on upstream conditions. Subcritical flow, on the other hand, is the state where fluid velocity is below the sonic value, and the production rate is dependent on both downstream and upstream pressures. We can see that in the graph, where the trend of the flow rate is linear in critical condition, and when passes in subcritical condition, the line starts to bend. The boundary between critical and subcritical flow regimes is approximately defined by a value of 0.5 and 0.6, and this is the transition point. So we started our work with an accurate quantitative and qualitative literature analysis, in order to have a comprehensive understanding of problem and the areas that needed to be improved. Extensive studies were conducted in the last 60 years, and more than 50 papers about a model or a simple equation to predict oil flow rate have been published. The existing choke models are generally classified into two main groups: the theoretical models and the empirical ones. The theoretical models are used more often by the oil and gas industry because of their ability to simulate the physical phenomena, to calculate the flow boundary conditions, and to their capability to calculate the flow rate with better accuracy. The challenge that the author of these papers met is that the flow entering the choke is difficult to model because it's not homogeneous and can have different flow patterns. Also, the geometry of the choke is very, very complex. Therefore, a small change in the condition upstream of the choke can give larger deviations in predict mass flow rate than expected. After the literature analysis, we decided to select for the comparison with our new equation two theoretical models widely used in oil and gas industry, Sachdeva et al. Model and Perkins model. Additionally, we selected and studied the Gilbert equation. It is an empirical correlation valid only for critical flow that will be useful also for the explanation of our equation proposed in this work. Just to have an idea of the complexity of the models selected in our calculation, we want to show the final form of Sachdeva and Perkins. The final equations of the model are capable of both finding boundary between critical and subcritical multiphase flow and calculating the flow rate through choke. But is how we can see is not practical for a digital field calculation because the models are very, very complex. So we finally arrived to the main part of our work: the importance of field digitalization. Field digitalization is a current emerging trend that have substantial growth in the last few years in oil and gas industry. It means that some digital technologies are being used in the processes and managing data digitally real time in order to convert processes into processes more efficient, more productive and more profitable. Effective use of digital solution can increase, as we said, productivity, efficiency and agility by making precise business decisions more reliably, and the number of collaboration of oil and gas company and technology company is rising a lot in the last few years. Digital ISO is already a key part of reducing cost, decision making and worker productivity. In digital oil field, we can gather real-time millions of input data. Put simply, we are now able to analyze more data in more ways than ever before. For that reason, we need to reduce the parameters required for the calculation of flow rate in subcritical flow and make or try to make the models that we saw before simpler for practical digital field uses on which we have a lot quantities of data. Real time. For all the reasons explained before, we try to formulate a new equation for flow through a choke in digital field calculations. That is the main purpose of our work. As we said before, the practical field utility of a choke correlation depends on its accuracy, simplicity, and on a limited number of input flow data. Most of the models described above utilize a set of equations to estimate well flow rate through well head chokes that implies the availability of a lot of parameters that is not always available in field. For that reason, we try to propose this new empirical formula in order to reduce the parameters required for the calculation of flow rates in subcritical flow, considering that for practical field use, it is often preferable to use a simplified formula that can be easily calibrated with few field flow data. In order to do that, we based on the Gilbert type formula that is valid only for critical flow and try to extend this type of correlation to subcritical flow by inserting the pressure downstream of the choke that has to be always present in subcritical flow. Generally, this correlation was based taking into account the flow boundary conditions and the transition point between critical and subcritical flow. We start from an equation derived from our experience, and that roughly represents the choke flow in subcritical condition. The original form of the equation is shown here, and where the P1 is the pressure upstream, the P2 is the pressure downstream, and the Q0 is the oil flow rate at standard conditions, and the B and N are numerical coefficients. We can note that when N is equal to 2, this equation became simply Bernoulli equation. An example of any correlation for critical and subcritical flow through choke is graphically represented here. And in this example, the pressure downstream of the choke is fixed at 200 psi. This graph shows that under critical flow condition, the trend is linear, and when we move to critical condition, where P1 to P2 is less than 2, the line starts to bend, as we said before in the general theory. This is obvious from a theoretical point of view, considering that under critical flow conditions, the pressure downstream of the choke doesn't affect in any way the calculation of flow rate. The black square represents the transition point R that can be defined as the boundary condition between critical and subcritical flow condition. From this graph of general validity, we made some assumption. The two curves have, as we can see in the graph, one point in common, that is the transition point, that corresponding to the change of flow condition. And we can say that in this point, the two curves have the same derivative. Then we, assuming in line with the field experience, the transition point between critical and subcritical flow R equal to 2. As we said before, we started our analysis with two equations. One is the equation explained before, that is a starting equation that I call here E0. The other one is the Gilbert equation that we know is valid only for critical flow. The procedure can start and calling QCR the rate in correspondence to the transition point R, the boundary between critical and subcritical condition. Its value can be easily obtained using the equation for critical condition at the transition point and considering at this point the pressure upstream of the choke equal to the transition point times the pressure downstream of the choke. As shown here, we can found the equation 1. At this point, the two equations are equalized and we get the equation 2. At this point, we know that the derivatives that are shown here for critical and subcritical flow are equal. We can equalize these two derivatives, finding the equation 3. Now, the equation 2 and the equation 3 can be put in a system of two equations with two unknowns, B and N. The equation 3 can be rearranged and the QCR can be substituted with the equation 2, obtaining the equation 4. Now, inserting the equation 1 in the last equation, we can easily obtain the equation 5. We can extract B from the equation 2 and considering A from Gilbert, we can generate the equation 7. Now, at this point, inserting the equation 0, say the starting equation in the equation 7, we can finally found the equation 6 that describes the pressure upstream of the choke. The initial form of the new equation can be easily obtained extracting the flow rate, that is the output data that we want to obtain. As we can see, the initial form of new equation for subcritical flow through choke still seems a little complicated. In order to further simplify it, we want to make another assumption. We know from the literature that the transition point R that defines the boundary between critical and subcritical flow is approximately 1.7 or 2. Considering that this equation has to purpose to simplify the estimation of flow rate and that it's very hard to calculate the boundary conditions between critical and subcritical flow with a simple formula, in line with our field experience, we want to consider the transition point R equal to 2. Now, substituting R equal to 2 in the initial form of the new equation, we get finally the final form of our new equation proposed in our study. We can see that with only four parameters, that are the pressure upstream, pressure downstream, the diameter of the choke and the gore, we can describe the subcritical flow through a wellhead choke. The basic input data that the choke multiphase performance models and new equation require in order to work properly are upstream choke pressure, the downstream choke pressure, the choke valve diameter and the gas oil ratio, that is the ratio between the volume of gas that comes out of solution and the volume of oil start standard conditions. Then, in addition, Sachdeva and Perkins, the most widely choke models used in the oil and gas industry, require other parameters in order to compute the fluid properties, as shown in the next table. The qualitative and quantitative analysis of new equation and existing models was possible by the creation of a field database. Our field database was composed by data coming from different fields of different countries around the world. This choice comes from the need to test and evaluate the models and the new equation under different conditions, types of fluids and type of flow. During my internship at TNI SPA, we were able to collect flow data coming from Norwegian offshore fields, Angola, Italy, and Nigeria onshore fields. For each wells of different fields, we decided to cut off the input flow data that didn't bring substantial variation in terms of results, having the same value of differential pressure across the choke diameter, or core. For this reason, the final field database was composed by more than 800 subcritical and 120 critical field flow data. We proposed this table in order to better understand the number of parameters included in the calculation of each models and correlation. We want to remark the difference in terms of number of parameters included in the calculation between Sachdev and Perkins and our new equation proposed in this work. We want to underline that our new equation is comparable with the Gilbert equation, that is the simplest multiphase flow model, so correlation, but with the difference that our equation can be used also in the subcritical flow. Our methodology of work is very basic. We prepared an Excel spreadsheet on which implement all the equation of models and which implement our new equation. Then we insert the input data gathered in the Excel spreadsheet in order to start the simulation and obtain the oil gas flow rate as output data. Finally, we compared the results coming from each models and coming from the new equation in order to see if our new equation can be comparable with the most sophisticated models present in the literature. Three statistical approaches and a graphical representation were chosen for the quantitative evaluation and the comparison of the choke models and our new equation. The evaluation criteria was based on the average relative error that indicates the difference between the predicted mass flow rate by each model and by the new equation and the measured flow rate in the field at the same condition. Then we based our evaluation criteria on the average absolute error that calculates the absolute value of each error before taking the average and combines the features of standard deviation and the relative error. Then finally the last criteria was the standard deviation that measures the amount of spread around the relative error. We put here an example of subcritical flow data result of new equation for Nigeria fields data. From the quantitative evaluation and the results, our new equation show a good precision and accuracy with an average absolute error of 17.5% that is comparable with the average absolute error of such DEVA models, the best model to predict oil flow rate for multiphase flow through chocks, that is 17.2. From the previous discussion and the analysis of results, we can draw the following conclusions. We can say that the database that we have built can be considered very representative with wide ranges of oil rates, pressures, gore, choke sites, and fluid characteristics. For critical flow, it is recognized that the best correlation is for sure the one proposed by Gilbert in 1954, demonstrated and calibrated with our critical flow data. The multiphase subcritical flow is much more complex to model than the critical ones, and many sophisticated methods were proposed in the last 60 years. With the field digitalization, there is a growing need to have reliable and simple correlations constantly calibrated with the abundant field data in order to correctly back allocate the well oil rates. And last, the new equation proposed in this work, and this is also valid for subcritical flow, on the basis of its reliability and simplicity, appears to be preferable to the sophisticated models and helpful most of all for practical field applications. We have two remarks that the numerical coefficients of the formula don't come from regression analysis of our field dataset. Thus, they have general validity. We want to conclude this presentation analyzing the pros and the limitation of our new equation proposed in this presentation. The advantages of a new equation for sure is that this equation is simple and valid also for subcritical flow. The equation required a few parameters in order to work properly, and the unique fluid characteristic required is the GOR. The other parameters required are the upstream and downstream pressure and the choke diameter. Is very practical and useful for digital field application where we have a lot of data real time. It's very easy to understand and apply. The results show that this equation have a good accuracy and precision and is comparable with the best model present in the literature, SESH-TEVA. That is very much more complex than our equation. Other advantages, the last is the numerical coefficient, that the numerical coefficient of this equation don't come from regression analysis of our field dataset. They have general validity. The limitation is that this equation doesn't work with small choke diameter, and however, this type of the diameter of choke less than 8/64 inch is rarely used in a field in oil and gas industry. For simplicity, then, during the procedure of the equation, we assumed that the boundary critical subcritical flow corresponds to a ratio of pressure upstream and pressure downstream equal to 2. This is a rule of thumb well known in field. This is an assumption, but this is derived from the experience in field. So thank you very much for your attention, and if you have many questions, I will be more than happy to answer. Thank you.
Pier Paolo, here is your first question. How did you establish the numerical coefficient of the new equation?
So, good point. In order to establish the numerical coefficients of the new equation proposed in this work, we did a calibration by regression analysis of two assumptions made during the validation of our equation. One was the parameter A of Gilbert equation, and the other one was the value of the transition point that we assume equal to 2. We try to calibrate these two values in order to see how the parameter for our flow test data changed. Having all the parameters and doing a simple regression analysis using the solver Excel, it was possible to obtain the value of parameters calibrated. According to the result of the calibration, and considering that the calibration is only possible once we have already the measured value of oil flow rate, that in our computation is our output data, we can say that with the calibration of Gilbert parameter and the changes of the transition point between critical and subcritical, the new equation doesn't increase its performance remarkably. For this reason, we can assume the original form of this correlation as valid for multi-phase flow rate through wellhead chokes. This is one of the advantages, as we said before, of the new equation. The parameter, in fact, don't come from regression analysis of our field dataset.
Your next question is, can be the field data used in the calculation considered reliable?
As we said before, our field database was composed by wide ranges of input flow data, and we selected fields from different countries around the world in order to have different conditions, type of flow, and type of fluids. For sure, the input flow data collection was one of the most critical parts of this work. a lot of time was spent to collect and homogenize the data that that belonged to different databases and documents. Since the data come from fields production, many of data points gathered are very similar in both pressures, mass fraction, or choke size. For this reason, for each well of different fields, we decide to cut off the input flow data that didn't bring a substantial variation in terms of results, having the same value of differential pressure across the choke diameter, or GOR. For example, flow data from Goliath, a Norwegian offshore fields, were collected by sensors that gathered all the information with a time of sampling of 5 seconds for a period of almost 3 years. The final input database was composed of about 14 million of flow data points. From this flow data, we selected, after an accurate analysis, only those who had a substantial variation in terms of pressure, choke size, or other input data. Many other flow test data for which we didn't have reliable flow input data or lack of information were eliminated in order to make more accurate our analysis. And the input flow data collection, as we said before, was one of the most critical parts of this work. For all that reason, we can consider the flow database reliable.
Thank you, Pier Paolo, for your good presentation. The time is over.
Thank you very much. I wish you a good continuation, and I hope to see you in the next year at the US Conference 2022. Thank you all. For any information, don't hesitate to contact me.
I wish you all a very nice day. Bye-bye.